faith members should all have received an email advising you of this coming into force when it did, so you should have been pre-warned. What you've got on page 189 is a slightly amended reporting format, and on paragraph 2c of that you will see that officers now in reports are being asked to be very clear when they're asking for delegations of power, so that members can be clear about exactly what you're delegating and can make decisions about what does and does not need to be published in writing. And that, Chair, is the regulations in brief. At page 193 onwards, you've also got a guidance document from DCRG, which explains in fairly plain language the requirements and what those might be. And I would advise you to read that at your leisure. I'm happy to answer any questions, Chair.
Colleagues, any questions, points, observations? You're very much welcome. Anybody who wants to come to our meetings? See the magnitude of the things we do? Keep Merseyside a safe place. Councillors.
Thanks, Chair. Just on paragraph 11, what we see says that people have the right to request the whether it's being taken bodily or being filmed. Is there any maximum number that was at a time be mischievous? Can any number of people get that request when they expose it as to provide that information to the whole country?
Chair, the regulations don't stipulate any maximum number. However, what can happen in your own constitution is there is any disruption to proceedings, and the chair of a particular meeting needs to bring that to order. And there are provisions in your constitution for how you need to do that. I am proposing to bring a draft protocol to members about these issues, so that can also be added into the constitution in terms of making these facilities available to people who want to record meetings, but also to ensure that proceedings go forward properly and that there isn't any disruption. And I'm hopeful that we'll have that ready in the near future.
I was more trying to get over the fact that if, for instance, somebody of you individuals wanted to obviously ask me to speak to them, because we're newsroom staff quite dramatically, we would not have the resource available to put out copies for large groups. People
think there's a general level of openness. Parliament, although we have to be falling to a dragging and kicking screen, Parliament and the proceedings of Parliament are available on television. We could televise, video cast, every single meeting. Lancashire County Council, I know used to do that. There's nobody, they're doing all this, nobody up there watching us. There's nobody, they're just that level of public interest, it's not there. For the normal proceedings on non-controversial matters, 90% is plus one rule. It's when we deal with a few controversial matters. I think Councillor Ayres is correct. My experience was the first time that I came across the latest rules was dealing at Sefton Council, a full council meeting in the gallery, dealing with the Greenbelt review, the strategic review, lots of people with big cameras, flashing cameras in people's faces, and aggressively trying to make a point to recently elected members, well, we're going to photograph you, or we're going to put you on a picture of the paper. Actually, this is all quite rubbish, it's all nonsense. I think we should openly and welcome people, to take an interest in what we do. And if they want to involve new media, new means of communication, well, that's good for all many lessons. But I think if it becomes in any way aggressive or intimidatory, then that's a job for the chair of the meeting and the authority itself to police the meetings. And we'll hope sense of the problem that won't happen. Otherwise, reports here, colleagues, for note and for action. The action will be the upgrading and updating of our constitution, the legal parts obviously we adopt. If there are no further comments or observations on this item,